range of outbreaks, expect more animal diseases to emerge. We are at the peak of the information age, in which many industries and things are powered by data and digital devices. But this age may spawn another, the age of outbreaks. After monkeypox, fear sparked that diseases jumping from animals to humans may cause another pandemic. If that happens, we are heading to an even bigger mess. New stuff and innovations happen every day. Some are good and some are bad. Yet the digital age is leading us closer to the fourth industrial age. Thanks to digital devices, the Internet of Things, big data, robotics, and AI, industries are rapidly changing where interconnectivity and smart automation serve are the core. Unfortunately, digitalization isn't the only thing skyrocketing. Zoonoses seem booming as well just after we endured COVID-19 for 2 years. According to the Minnesota Department of Health, these are infectious diseases transmitted from animals to humans or from humans to animals, though the term is more used for the former. In the U.S., the zoonotic diseases of most concern are zoonotic influenza, salmonellosis, West Nile virus, plague, emerging coronaviruses, rabies, brucellosis, and Lyme disease, as per the CDC. The most recent in the spotlight is monkeypox. The 2022 monkeypox outbreak sparked concern because it started in non-endemic areas and kept developing without an apparent pattern. With the surprise attack, can we expect more zoonoses to come our way? We should. About 60% of known human infections and 75% of new and emerging infectious diseases are zoonotic. That's a lot, and we face them daily. Wild animals have drastically changed their behaviors in response to human activities, migrating from their depleted habitats, said Oliver Restiff, epidemiologist at the University of Cambridge, per Medical Express. The main reason for the rising zoonosis is human activities. We are expanding faster than evolution itself, and animals can't keep up with us. As we invade their territories, poor animals have to seek new habitats to survive. Yet that isn't enough, for they need time to adapt to the changes. We continue to push animals to crowd themselves in limited areas. Imagine a crowded train during rush hour, except filled with wildlife, but this one never ends. Not to mention our role in global warming that's melting frozen lands, killing polar bears and other Arctic animals. If calling every animal cross your mind, that's not a good idea. Zoonosis specialist Benjamin Roach explained that deforestation cuts biodiversity. This depopulates animals, which are responsible for regulating viruses in the wild. Animals that got sick due to poor ecosystems would have lower immune systems, letting viruses jump from them to humans. Experts recommend better surveillance because we need to be ready. Otherwise, we will add another pandemic to our list. Do you agree that human activities contribute to zoonotic diseases? What do you think we should do? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.